Well, everyone, thank you all so much once again for tuning in. Please remember to use your hashtags wisely and make them go like this. Hashtag Zack Snyder's Justice League, hashtag release the air cut, hashtag Alita sequel, and hashtag Alita Army. If you've stuck with me this far during my mostly successful non-denominational run on YouTube, you know that I'm mostly a DC fan, and most of the Marvel stuff I really enjoy is outside of the MCU, aside from some exceptions. Point blank period, like a city girl. Anyways, by now, myself and all of my fellow DC fans are still rejoicing after Zachary Edward Snyder swooped and saved 2020, which made all of us go shut up and take my money. To every single person who hashtag released the Snyder Cut, male or female, I say this, thank you and congratulations because we are all part of history. And for some reason, I strongly believe that there is no flight plan for DC, and that the only way us, the fans, and then the studio can go is up. Thank you, Zach, for inspiring people everywhere, and thank you, AT&T, for taking the reins from WB and ultimately doing what is necessary. There are other hashtags existing with hopes of reviving shows, continuing franchises, and spawning sequels. Some I've mentioned in times past, and one of those is hashtag release the air cut. Now, back in 2016, Suicide Squad released to financial success and an almost widespread critical beating, aside from that one YouTuber by the name of Jeremy Johns. Now, at the time, some of us at least knew that the movie underwent reshoots, but once again, we didn't know just how severe the reshoots were. Joss Whedon's Russian family-led movie premiered a year later, and thankfully a hashtag that started small became something glorious and incredible. Every now and then you'd hear David say something in regards to Suicide Squad, but it seems that now with Zack Snyder's Justice League finally upon us, David has become very vocal in regards to the true OG cut of Suicide Squad. Now, most of these details I will cover at a later date, but to those listening, I say this once again. Do not forget David Ayer and Suicide Squad. Do not forget David Ayer and Suicide Squad. There's certainly a reason why he's revealing more details, and I don't doubt that the guy that wrote Training Day wanted to just make an okay movie. You don't go from King Kong and Alonzo Harris to Jiggity Funkity We Want the Funk with Lady You Are Evil like that, unless you're being micromanaged. With everything David has said so far, I believe he was put in a very difficult situation, and it's only because the actors slash actresses have such good chemistry that the movie is just okay.
But, Josh Samuel, if you like Suicide Squad, the theatrical cut right now, why are you talking about the Ayer cut? Hey, listen, man, shut up!
Because I believe that David Ayer's Suicide Squad was the start of something great. It's clear that his OG version ties into some of Zack's plans with what he had going, and I suspect it is likely edited at least more cohesively as well. When I watch Suicide Squad, there are moments where you can clearly tell David was going for something big. But WB's fear and believing the bitch-assery of social media that we saw at the time caused what I like to call a reactionary cut. If you hire someone to do a job like Jared Leto, don't trim his screen time down to almost zero. Don't hire a filmmaker to do a job and not allow him or her to finish what he or she started and be surprised that a hashtag campaign is started. When I say do not forget David Ayer, I wholeheartedly hope that you remember artistic integrity, creative freedom, and that his movie was also forcibly reshot. As I script this particular video, David has revealed so much that it's painfully obvious just how watered down his Suicide Squad was. For whatever excitement we had for Jared Leto as Joker, we were sadly given a measly 10 minutes, if that, of screen time, and barely had any interactions with he and Harley outside of the ones that we saw. All in all, I hope the excitement of Zack Snyder's Justice League only inspires everyone listening to hashtag the Ayer cut of Suicide Squad, because it is indeed a case of what we saw and what was originally shot are two totally different things. I suspect that that iconic photo floating around of Zack and David ultimately has more meaning than we possibly realize, and that the WB regime at the time enabled viewers to see belly dancing demigods. The success of the Ayer cut could possibly lead to David doing Gotham City Sirens, seeing as the other guy is doing that movie called The Suicide Squad. It's really a fascinating scenario though. Harley Quinn's popularity and Suicide Squad still being a financial success somehow moved this trilogy forward, and we are likely going to see David's OG version. But I think AT&T still will definitely want to hear why we, the audience, want to see it, and nonetheless, regardless of if you like David's theatrical cut or not, I feel like it's the right thing to do. So keep the same energy for David Ayer and the Suicide Squad, and just imagine how cool it would be to see persons like Margot Robbie, Will Smith, Jay Hernandez, Jared Leto, Cara Delevingne, and Adewale tweet hashtag release the Ayer cut at some point, just like the entire Justice League did for Zack Snyder. I suspect that if enough noise is made about the movie, like what is currently occurring at the present, then that will likely end up being the case. But at any rate, keep fighting for it if you believe in artistic integrity, creative freedom, and more. I've always been of the mindset that we didn't see enough of Jared Leto as Joker to form a solid enough opinion of whether he was actually good or not. But the glimpses we did see showed that Leto really took his time to dip into the insanity of the Clown Prince of Gotham. The other thing is, if there is indeed another version of Suicide Squad out there that is more cohesive and less pop-filled, who wouldn't want to watch it? Zack Snyder's Justice League was only the start, but I sense that the Ayer cut releasing would also be a much bigger win for Warner Brothers than perhaps even they are aware of. The possibilities are endless, and this is only the start. And with that being said, stay focused, keep the same energy, and I promise you all that we will see the same victory.